16th to the 8th. That's four. Got the job of time of towing the Linden. Run, row from sea. To pick the banger. We've got aboard a good two. The legged.
Hey!
Right, mate. We got young Nicholas. Come on, Nicholas. That's it. And we've got Mikey. How are you now, mate?
Pretty.
Well, we've got Peter, another 13, 14. We've got Gareth there. How old are you now, Gareth?
12.
Well, okay. I've never been kissed, Andy, lad. Well, we towed the Lindham out with the rowers, and we left the rowers now on the outside mooring, and we're going to do the trip with the Lord of Jane. Now, just about 9 a.m. We're a bit late leaving the show. Off. We'll end them on a reasonable size stone. We can pour our roads, look after the dough, till we get back. Start off 3 p.m. Thank you. Well, we've tied up to Bangor Pier to go and see Dickies, but we find that Bangor Pier at the end of it is all locked up, and we can't get off the end there. So we'll have to think again now. Yeah, well, as I said, we've got the boat moored up alongside the pier at Bangor with the big gazelle. And all that going on in the background, but unfortunately we can't get there. We haven't got a big enough thing. Oh well, not to worry. But here we are, as I say, and we're going to have to think now how to take the keys to the Lindum, which is moored up, and one of Dickie's moorings, and there it is. So we'll be taking the keys in and buzz off. You know, shortage of steels around here at the moment. Ha 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 ha! here we are. Really, amongst the bloody mackerel. Just look at this lot here, all jumping right alongside us. There's our kids in the dinghy. And we're whopping them in here as well. Go on, Gibson, eat your bloody arse out. Your granddaughter there. Just at the back of this job, just outside the harbour. I'm in 6 feet of water. And here's the fish jumping in the water. And where are we? Right outside Mike's house, I'll see you. Well, it doesn't very often stay like this, but it's nice to see. Well, I'm only on a short trip. Andrew's been way out. He said he's only had 6 bishops an hour, so he's coming to join us. Well, they are, look at that. They have been whopping a lot in.
Oh, they have.
Well, this sort of says it all now, look. In the bloody harbour itself, and we're outside. Well, it's incredible. A marvellous to see it. Now look at that thing. Well, that close. Well, yeah, we got Martin. He's left his restaurant. He's pulling him off the beach. Look at that, eh? Can't be bad. Two at a time off the shore. That's the way to do it! In the harbour now, and there are still mackerel about, and we have still been catching. Oh, it's a rain now, lovely. So it keeps the scales nice and wet, doesn't it? Yeah, they're jumping inside the breakwater there. Have you got any more?
Can't get it off.
We've locked your service, look. Oh, look at that lot there, eh? Well, looks like they're heading towards the right speed. Come on, there we come. There they are. Anyway, get your line in, madam. Well, I've just heard from you, Jackson. For the Harbour entrance now. They catch them on the jetty.
Yeah.
And we're getting some here as well.
The reach out there, we charge me around here. It's 26 quid. Just look all out. It's bloody wood, aren't they? If you've got any batteries, they have 2 seconds to complete, and it costs you 15 quid.
Right. Yeah.
was at a spa. According to contemporary wills, one cupboard, three stools, one table and a bench. People probably stood more in those days. The table and the bench were the master's high table at the upper end of the hall. Behind the high table, a doorway led to a room for working and sleeping, the parlor.
Oh, 16 to 10. Well, my parlour doesn't sign. Cool, John. I say, since I was Will Patmos, and today is my first mate, I have... Johnny, notice you wearing the Admiral's hat. She's done about there catching fish. She's using her mother. She's been using her t-shirt, as a bloody towel, which no doubt you'll have to clean. And now I know that. Aye? She's washing it, I should think so, too. Nice day, Johnny, isn't it?
Brilliant.
Lovely sunny day.
Yeah,
and relatively calm. Aye?
Very same with
that. I'm relatively calm. Well, we'll get on with this fishing again.
The Gosani College are doing Lock Up Your Daughters at their brand new theatre. Welcome to Music and Drama performing at the...
They say about that, out in the noonday sun. Now, we have life. Gonna have a little doze up there, have you? Jenny, little doze. Sunbathing. You've got the sun, your face is nice and red now. Well, time for off, I think.
Also in the programme.
That's about a lot, wasn't it?
Jenny!
Oh, we're on our way home now. And it's been a really lovely day. One of the lady anglers is on the wheel in charge. One of the glasses, we can't recognise her. I come aboard in the dinghy, and the most of the petrol ran out. Stuart, what do you think of the trip so far? Can you sum it up in two words or one word? Good lad, Pete, you did a good job there. We never knew we were going to do so much running damage to put more petrol in. Curry mix, and there's the good old sausages. We've already made a start with some of them. It's reasonably hot mix. Part of the mix is this, a cold West Indian hot dog sauce. It's quite hot. Very tasty. Hello, Wendy. Oh, I've lost it. Hello there, Wendy.
So what kind of...
There's a skillet, so I can't see him. You're going down, all right?
Just dropped the proper one.
Very good job. He's making me merry, Stuart.
Right,
your rest
are,
good.
Hey? I can be first to seven. Young Peter now. Oh,
You what? What did they cast off, Mr. Mate?
The
make sure there's no bubbles around you.
Otherwise,
around there now in Milan's boat. Huh? If you want to buy him something for Christmas, Daddy, buy him that. Milani wants $4,000 for it. That's with a foot on it, he'll fill the tank of petrol for that price.
And there we are. Oh, look at little Snoopy's tail wagging behind you, Tate. You can move on these, you know. Now there's Bonnie, who's very interested in the chockies that are going about. And there's Tate, and the nice little laugh. And we're shorting. Oh, dirty. Hello, Snoopy. How are you? Have a little dither, that's it. Mmm, very nice. It's nice, isn't it, Casey? Eh? That's it.
Well, here we are. On the 27th of the 7th. Sometime in the afternoon, where is it? Oh, there you are. Quarter past five, and we've come out to the Skipper Tallon. I've got young Gareth with me as we mate today. He's doing a grand job. Down. So we come out to have a look at the edit. And there she is. Yeah, so there. Marion and Jane, there's your lad. Battling with the elements. Look, eh? And he done well. Give your mum a wave, Gareth. There you are. Have you caught any fish today, Gareth?
Yeah.
Ah, that's the way to do it. Great, so yeah, a bit of waves going up and down now, eh? What the hell? Can't be bad. Yeah, so there we are. We'll be going in. I think we're due in about 6:30 tonight. That's our final. As I say, it's a bit lumpy getting the board, but they are, we managed to get the supplies and stuff on the board. So we're down to the stages. Mike and Tom managed to get a bit of some spuds, some carrots. No, not carrots, beans, that was it, beans and some bread. And we brought the paper and milk. Did it quite tough when we went alongside?
Yeah.
Did you find me on there? Yeah. Hey, looks like you're in the quite a television star, Gareth. In charge of the ship now, mother. Heading for home? We're going home, we won't be late. He said he hoped we missed the tide, so we'd have to stop out for him. Said he can't stand your dinners any more. He's fed up with beans on toast. Is that what you said? He's fed up with beans on toast, that's it, I say. And your dad's singing in the bath, is that right? There you are, you see. Okay.
He'll fix you up.
We have a job to do for BBC Wales. They're doing some filming some jet skis. Just arrived on site and they've asked us to just clear off a bit and hang about for about an hour. That's exactly what we're doing. Young Peter Doyle's on the wheel. Well, we're sort of waiting to see what's happening. In the meantime, on the radio is Nikki, Mike off the Conway Star, who's just going to cover a sailboat in. Another job that these lads have got here, they've got the Llandudno ILB doing some standby work, and they've just having a quick cuppa. Looking a bit bashful, some of them, but they are. That's it. All right, lads. Where's your leader today, Danny?
On the beach.
He's what?
On the beach.
He's on the beach?
On the beach today,
he can't be bad. Lovely day, though, isn't it? Absolutely. Just ask you where the coxswain is, and I'm informed he's on the beach. So no doubt he's amongst that lot somewhere. Which one? We don't know. I don't see much gold braid, so I'm not sure where he is. I brought my admirals up today to our ranking men.
Where are you from?
Is
that the one?
Really lovely day here. Just come along the shore, and I see the Llangollen fishing boat. Seems to be doing quite well. We're coming to the jetty now. Yeah, some people on the jetty. And the saucy salt just sailed, and it looks like the Neptune going in. Plenty of people on the pier. Hardly a ship in the bay, what a bloody shame. Well, the
The ILB's going to pack in now. Unimog's just come to pick him up. And they'll be loading him up. And away they go any time now. We're just waiting for one more man to come. They'll finally come back to the hotel. But he's under instructions to get his ass down here. And we'll have to pick him up in the dinghy as best we can. Well, we sent Pete and Sean out to pick up the extra man. And there he is. Looks like he's left something behind. There we go again. As young Peter makes for the show, with two of the crew, how's that about the jetty? Over there, come on. Lovely afternoon here at Flandern now. Got the tide too low, so the Neptune and the Saucy Sal are anchored out. Well, poor old Pete is about knackered.
Did he have anything?
Yes, he's taking the fish ashore. Careful to go now. Well, we've moved round now. We come to a little home. Pete and I are going to go into the cave. It's low, just about low tide and quite a big tide. We're going into that cave there. Oops, folks, right, there we are. We're going into that cave there. It should be nice. Under a high spot. Well, here we are, and there's the road, and here's my mate Peter. I know inside the cave, and he's struggling because it's all jelly. All right, Peter?
Yeah?
Are you touching bottom? Well, this now is looking into the cave. All the beach is covered in shingle. Quite high in here. Plenty of room. Yeah, another little entrance there. And here's the beach coming down to where the dinghy is. Well, I've walked to the back of the cave. Peter's just come out of the water. There's the dinghy I came ashore in. Right, two little entrances, another one over there. And just above that entrance is a hole in the roof with daylight. We'll go and have a look at it in just a moment. There's all sorts of little nooks and crannies here. There's another little gap in the rocks. Take some beach again. Well, I'm now looking at the hole, the vent. Long way up. We come down. There we come, coming down, down, down. All the way down here. And then we have Peter wandering around. All right, Pete?
Yeah.
Good, is it?
Big shingle.
Eh?
Big shingle.
It is, isn't it?
Yeah. But I don't like jellyfish, though.
Another little view of the vent. Slightly different angle. Coming down. Pick up the light from outside now.
There we are. There's Peter paddling round. Come to the dinghy. Or going to the dinghy.
So there we are. There's the boat. Back out to the boat. I think we're just about finished this shot off now. On a really lovely day. July 94. Well, Peter's just pushing us off now. I believe in the cave. Okay, come aboard, Peter. You can make, well, pull the boat up a bit then, go on. Pull it in a bit. There's the cave. And the shingle rest at the back there. The second entrance over there. It's gone a bit deep for him now, he's gone.
It's a drop off.
A drop off there, he says. Okay, me old spud.
Yeah. Hi.
The light's catching you now, all right.
Sun's
okay, away you go, spud. Next thing on our trip is a visit, quick visit to the Roseniger buoy. The Roseniger wreck, rather. That's at the crankshaft. And the remains of the paddle wheels. We're a bit late getting here, actually. And a bit behind it is the boiler. What's left of the boiler? This wreck went down in about 1910, if I remember rightly. It's a submerged object and sank whilst on his way to roast on sea pier. So just pulling slowly away from it. How are you doing, eh? Well, I've just come to the Schooner car park here, where we get ready for the bonfire. We've got Dave Price in charge looking after it, and his daughter here. And what's your name again?
Joan.
Say? Joan, that's it. And you've got the fjord in charge of the fairground ride here?
No, it's someone else's doing.
Oh, yeah.
And it's cold.
Well, as I say, there's a little ride here for the kids when they get here tonight. So it looks like it should be a nice little evening. The bonfire itself is all fenced off. And look at that one.
Lord.
It may not be very high, but there's certainly a lot of stuff there. Whoops. The ticket machine isn't part of it. There we are, look at that lot. There's a real mountain of stuff. Well, I've closed into the bonfire now, and I recognise that. That's the shovel I threw away. It's ended up on the bonfire somehow. But there's no shortage of anything. Quite good condition doors. Seats. Usual bonfire stuff, but it's a hell of a covering, a hell of a big. It's not very high, but it's covering a fair old area. Look at that. We're down the other side of the bonfire now. And there certainly is plenty of stuff here. Well, there we have Dave and his daughter at the gate, strolling the area. All waiting for the big thing to happen. Plenty of water around here. Look after the place.
just back round to the bonfire to finish off before it gets lit. Good crowd here at Schooner tonight. And growing by the minute. In that corner over there, we've got hot dogs going on. Don't know who's doing them. Well, I'm not too sure, but it looks to me like that's the beginning. It's right on the way. More people turning up.
The boat's spinning. The boat's spinning.
Well, we're making a start. We're up in so wet.
Oh, it's all right. We've got
to get it going.
It seems to be going all right.
Yeah, but we have to get all.
It's got to take time to get going.
See, look, they're lighting it at the
other
end,
so
we can go all the way
around
the street.
Yeah. Yeah.
You've
got to
be patient, your children.
It's got a light.
Well, it's done. Take a bit of hole now.
Yeah.
Things are getting better.
Yeah. I have to go into the gate.
A bit over there. Hot dog stalls underway. Well, here we have the display team with out the back of Jim's van. We need to send up the first mortar.
All right, good night.
Well, we've got, got the lads here organising. We've got Gwyn there. You leaving, Gwyn?
I don't know. You all right, then?
OK, mate.
Very good, very good.
There goes another one, I think. Peter Gass is here, doing his bit.
Hello, John.
Good evening, Peter.
1988, fire is there. OK, so... landing on Peter's top.
Yeah, get the
step there.
Good,
Pete. He's landing around with a bucket now.
Tony's put his shirt, his yellow shirt on so he can get in one of the best positions. And his bucket. You should be going round with it though, Tony, not just standing here with it empty.
Go down there, then.
We paid $295.
Well, we're talking about the retail value.
What's this ring going off now, Jim?
Not sure.
They're all written in Chinese.
Oh.
I don't like it.
Now, how come you're not doing some collecting, Claire?
I'm getting the drinks in, but I'm not paying.
You get, oh, you were quick to say that there.
There'll be approximately 400 pounds of the fireworks being let off tonight. Please give generously towards the children's Christmas party.
All welcome.
All welcome. Have a boat ride down seaside. For the thrill, watch the fireworks in real.
Very good, Bob.
Oh, thank you.
Are you ready?
We can do without that.
Well, it's one. Oh, there we go.
Yeah, John Bradshaw.
book.
Well, we got a real turnout here tonight. The place is absolutely packed. Just look at this lot. Free show for the townspeople of Rill, eh? And what a lovely sight. We've got our collectors going round now, doing what they can to get towards it. As you've heard, there's Tony doing his little bit. Not a lot, but doing his little bit.
Yeah.
As you've heard, there's 400 quid that's going up here tonight. And Mr. Dobson has got them all in the back of his van. Whether his insurance covers this, we're not too sure.
Oh, shut up, will you? Cheers, anyway.
Right for the kiddies, after the bonfire, after the fireworks, come along and join in.
At the moment, the road is being closed off here because they're just in the process of building a new roundabout. Just on the road side of the bridge.
Next year, it'll be in the middle of the new roundabout.
Jim's van for doing the baked potatoes later on tonight. We're overlooking the harbour here. It looks like Eddie's. Oh, there goes a goodie. Parachute flare is getting very near the land. Now, very often they land on the ground. Oh, yeah. Okay there, Tone.
All right, yeah.
Well, Sonny Jim, oh, you enjoying it, Derek?
Yeah.
That's the way to do it. Well, the fire's certainly well underway now. And, as I said before, an excellent turnout. Mr. Bax, our chairman, is having a dual role in the dual race. Not sure, oh, there's our chairman, our president of the Bacon Bar. Mr. Olcott is back to the secretary. As usual, the men of the ladies inside. We got Ann. We got Audrey. The ex-social secretary and the chairman discussing tactics for the night. And there we have the secretary and Tom the president. But if they chop their arms off, they'd be dead. I mean, they'd be done. Well, there we have. We've even got a queue forming up now for the hot dogs. Thank you. thank you very much. You can see for yourselves. That'll be a good turnout here. Some of them I don't recognise some of the people. Plenty of adults and plenty of kids. Oh, you went on screen and you are now. You can wave now, baby. There you are. There's buddy packs and there's plenty in the pub as well. Look at that one. Well, the kiddie ride's doing well then. Oh, where's the good maroon gone off?
Don't you look in a seat, don't you?
What was that you said then, Kev?
I said it would have been better if you hadn't took all the wood.
That's pretty charming, isn't it? Where's, oh, look at that on camera. I like the face.
Sissy with his fingers in his ears.
I'll get you in a minute, please. Hello. I see Mr. Duck Jr.'s here anyhow. Dad's not very well, but how's your dad doing?
Not bad.
Come on, pick up his hand. You haven't lost, you're not short of any players on the boat here, right?
No, I don't know.
Oh, we've got the Ingham boys here. Oh, we've got one of them anyhow. Your brother's away tonight, is he?
Yeah, he's in France.
He's where?
In France.
In France? Hope he sends us a French letter. Right. Ah, there we have Derek. The last time I saw him was on the boat having a trip. Bloody hell, why does Jim keep standing in the road when they got to film someone? I'm not sure what he's done now, I can't quite see Mr. Dobber. Oh, there we are, we lit one, have we?
Yeah.
A rocket.
Rocket.
I think Jim likes to be star of the show here. Here we go. Oh, what's that one called, Jim? A razzmatazz?
Yeah.
Oh, bloody hell.
It's like you, John, razzmatazz.
Hey, what a bigger net, what a throbber.
Wouldn't mind, eh?
Hey? How you doing there, Glenny? Are you? Oh, hey, we're looking better now, a lot healthy now. Go and peep inside.
It's a free go.
Not very much. I've emptied it once.
Oh, well, can't be bad.
No.
Well, it's going to take a lot to make the £400 back for the fireworks.
Oh,
you're doing
my
a good
God,
job
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
When I'm leaning on the lamppost at the corner of the street, da 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 da, This is Mrs. Armstrong with Gibson.
Yes,
come on, Michael. You're in the shade as well.
This is James.
This is Sharon.
That's James, isn't it? Okay. Son number one's here as well. Hi, Gaz. With mother.
How nice not to see you.
Oh, yeah. Away the lads. Puts from Mark Street. Bloody Swinney. There we are, smoking.
Cheers, John.
Gaz, how you doing, my lad? Don't be bashful. What have you been doing that song, Darren?
Neil's been stretching
Brian.
Brian, I got it right away.
Neil's been stretching it.
There we have then. Girls? Well, this dancer's turned up as well, hasn't he? Rubber. I think it's his rubber, anyway. Give me lady. Oh, I like it, yeah. I wonder where he gets it from. Give us a big smile, Josh. Try once more. Good lad, good lad. Oh, I like it. I've got it.
Don't waste your hair there. The foul mood.
Where's his sister? Is she bashful, is she?
No, we've got one,
Al. What's that you say, mother? Well, it's 8:30, there's still plenty of people about.
Emily?
We're about to buzz off.
Emily,
well, following morning, 8:30 in the morning, just on my way to work, place is all empty. But hey presto, there's still smoke coming from the fire. Not a lot, a little. Ah, still some flames there, as you say, Tony. The site looks reasonably tidy now.
Conway in North Wales.
probably just get round Land's End today, but just wanted to inform you that we've sailed. There's three persons on board, and we'll give you a call when...
Tell me what you are then.
We'll be arriving at our next destination. We're actually locking 40, we're locking 40 foot down the road. It's now 14:20, still quite a bit choppy here. We're about 15 mile now, sort of west of Eddystone Lighthouse, so you can see.
We've got 21 miles to go to Palmer.
Taking a picture of Peter here. He's been sick a couple of times on this leg. Right, we'll knock it off now. And we have John now on the wheel. Just past Plymouth. Assumes
it's Plymouth Fever. Well,
quite choppy. John keeps dropping him off the bloody waves. And with us a leak in. £200,000 bloody boat. Also coming through the port forward window. Also the window.
Try not to turn the camera too fast, Eddie, but yeah. Dipping all the water dipping down on the controls.
The port outside window there, you can see quite a lot of water coming through. Towels all sorts of things, trying to mop it up. So hopefully we'll have to try and get something sorted out in Palmer.
Quarter to 8 in the morning, and last night we stayed at the Braemor Guest House in Palmer. It was very nice, accommodation very nice, we had a nice breakfast, well looked after. We got the taxi ordered for 8 o'clock. Take us to the marina, to the boat.
Just heading off from Palmer's marina now. That's been our berth there. And then Eddie's operating from the flying bridge. We'll be right back.
chamber. We wanted 29 pence a litre for fuel here. Yesterday we paid 17. On the jetty. Porter. There we have the main dock area. Simon, which we've got to pass before we get out.
To write down about that, it's a nice one, isn't it? Golden Fleece.
Yeah, well, on the flying bridge now. At the moment, it looks a lovely morning. We passed this big rig when we came in last night. Apparently it's been here about 4 years. Quite a sight. BT Marine, whether that's something to do with telecom, I don't know. Quite a big thing.
Looks like a cable layer, doesn't it, or something on the stern there.
Labouring a bit, don't they, when they do,
you know, hunting around. Like.
Well, there's the rig. Out there. just alongside the buoy, a mile from the harbour. Sunshine, and we're tied up very much amongst the fishing boats. The harbour seems full from end to end. Apparently most of the crew today have gone to the remembrance of the loss of the Penley lifeboat. It's the anniversary. We're tied up, as you can see, amongst the massive fishing boats. That's the way we came in through that gap there, to where we are now. Just going along the quay. The place is absolutely full of fishing boats. Whoops, some nets were passing then. And fueling wagons. Nets on bloody lorry loads of nets, look. And we're in one wing of the harbour, there's another one the other side. A couple of fuel tankers there. Yeah, very busy place. The boat that we're tied alongside, which is the broadsword of Myler, is a long liner. Not sure how many baskets of lines he's got, but he's got a hell of a lot. Sort of skate size, dogfish size hooks. And there certainly is a load of lines on board.
We're
just about to take mooring line ashore, but I've had to send Peter right round onto the other boat because the line's got to go over all this like a bloody cobweb onto that bollard up there somewhere or other. So we thought the easiest way was to send him round and I'll hopefully be able to chuck it across to him. That's the plan and we're going to have a plan.
BBC boat.
Well, they are, Pam. BBC. I come all this way, what do? I end up alongside the girl, Pamela.
Yeah. Now, we're going all see for
something. We're doing Peter and I now, we're just going ashore. Do some sussing out. Get Teddy on board. See where the boat is. Okay, Pete?
Yeah.
Plenty of boats here, isn't there?
Yeah,
and the other side of the harbour is as full. Well, the other side of the quay now, and it's absolutely packed with boats. They seem a lot bigger on this side. Doing a, I hope, a slow pan round. The place is full from the end to end with boats.
It's way below the background.
Well, just off the dock. We've you want to stand by the propeller blade, Peter? There's obviously a junkyard where they pick up bits and pieces. There's a quite a nice aeroplane propeller. Look at the size of that. All well sort of chewed up. In the background, just behind, there's a big anchor, is it, Pete? Where's it?
Yeah.
Aye. That'd suit your dad, wouldn't it?
Yeah, get the trolley down here.
Yeah. Yeah, so I'm going to chuck all the junk here by the look of it. Yeah, pair of engines, look like they come off the same aeroplane. King Peter and I have now walked the other side of the harbour, looking for some accommodation. Up to now, we ain't found any.
from here we get an idea of St Michael's Mount, if I can home in on it a bit. That's all the fishing boats. We're very sheltered here, but it's still quite breezy. Good view from here, Peter. We've walked all around the village down there. Only found one shop open. Well, there's only about six shops, but the pubs are doing well. Well, this is quite nice. There's one of the boats just coming out from the moorings, which I suppose we'll have to do tomorrow. Got plenty of fenders out, I see. Or footballs, as young Peter says. Now, didn't you make a good job of that now? And we, and I say we, I mean, the hunter's there, Daddy, in the next row. I wonder, was he watching me, I wonder, was he watching how it should be done. Now they are tightening the lines up again now. I suppose he's waiting to pick his mate up.
Shed then, Harvey. Right? Oh. How'd you get that? One of you
lot
or somebody else?
This little, only a very small boat. Same sort of bedding, quite a few there, not bad at all, that. There's nobody big. So you, Mr. Colton, no wheelhouse?
Oh my god.
Barry,
I'd
be
here. Anything's
supposed to kill? Thought the boat is alongside the fish quay at Newlyn.
Now, we don't often see this on the boat as well. We see these birds quite a bit, but we don't often see them first on the boat. There was two others with us a moment ago, but they buzzed off.
Well, this little oppo's come to join it now, look. Two of them. We don't get them near us in real.
Well, they are, there's four of them now. Young Peter thinks they must be Liverpool supporters because there appears to be a football on the deck and they're all watching it. It's 6:30 now. Newlyn Harbour's well lit up. Beamer here doing some work on. The old Pat. Across the harbour. It's really nice. A variety of Christmas lights, look at that, eh? Look at that little helicopter as well. Where's it? Right under a lovely moon. But he's shivering now, he's gone right cold. Well, as you can see, we're struggling here.
Am I under ventilating?
We're not on the boat. It's our accommodation, Newlyn. Yeah, Mother, there's Sully Jim. What time is it, Peter? 9:30. You're in bed? Is the hotel on? Is it nice? Oh, it's only all right. The other one's nice. So there we are, nice little room, telly, all in sweet. This is our little shower cubicle. And Lou, as you can see, we're very cosy here. And it's Sonny Jim's turn to switch the telly off tonight. Again.
We may not be ecstatic. He's
done it twice.
At least we're not rolling around in agony on the floor.
This is where we stopped last night. In Newlyn, or just on the outskirts of Newlyn. Found it very nice. Two stories near that. This is the offices of Stevenson and Sons, the trawler owner and operators, Newlyn. Right at the end of the quay. And I'm still on the edge of the fish market now. Loads of activity on the other side of me. Like some of those already landed. Say quite a lot of activity going on. And we're moored the other side of those boats, on the other side of that quay. Just over there. Like any stuff landed. Could have been foxes here. Nice to see that I've activity. Should be too long before we get to the Spaniards and the Portuguese. You're about to see the boat there. And on the quay, quite a bit of a tanker. I've stopped. I can see something hanging out underneath it there. I wonder what it is. What it is a little bird's nest in the chassis of the bumper. Pretty amazing. Just even on the bird now, it's 5 to 9. We've had quite a bit to do today. The moment is quite nice. And away we go. We've been anchored very close to the
behind the shed on the land. Let me know when we get one of these big swells that comes along, it all disappears.
Every now and again. But the waves were past it.
I've got the camera out, but there's nobody smells here, of course. But as you can see, plenty of spray. Oh, it looks like something's up here now.
Tuesday morning, and here we are in Milford Haven Marina. Had a bit of a do come in last night. The electronics went off. Just we're about to arrive at Milford Haven Sound. And then we've come into the old dock, and it's much changed since we were last here. It was dark when we came in last night. we were nicely tied up by 6:30. As you can see now, I'm just slowly panning around Milford Haven Marina. There's lots of fishing boats and all sorts in here. Not quite as full as Newland last night. There's still plenty of crap. Now, the accommodation last night was more or less that house there. It's a short walk away. Well, typically Eddie, first thing in the morning, found out it was a hose pipe. So we've got to wash the boat. We've been washing it for the last 30 bloody hours with high pressure bloody wash. Yeah, that's very smart. Any minute now we'll be leaving for the we'll be leaving to go into the lock, which is just a bit behind us. That ship there, the anchor man, we hear him on the radio sometimes up at our area. He's in here having some jobs done it. Where is it? Home in. There we are. The anchor man. Once again, looking at the charts, we're in Milford Haven Harbour, in the little dock which is here, in there. We've got to come out, go down the river, through the sound here. And then the plan is today that we're going to go along here, and through Jack Sound, and up there, where's the other one? Ooh, there we are, through there, and then that puts us to the other side of, you know, over by, what's the name of it? Fishguard, that's it. Hear that sound. As you can see, there's not much room through Jack Sound, though there's plenty of water. And as I say, we cross the bay here, and we come to Ramsey Sound. Not much room through there either, but once again, plenty of water. On the other hand, if we come out of Milford Haven, here, and come around, we go through some, we'll be going through some quite heavy overfalls all the way up here and all the way through there. So that's why we're hoping to go through the Annick. Short the distance and should be quite interesting. Another boat in the dock, but this is the Port Health Authority. The one of their men came aboard last night. Asked us where we come from. There's the lock entrance. And with us in the lock today is another little gig boat. The Cassionaire is almost closed.
Levels dropped and the gates are just starting to open from the lock. Meantime, now we'll be away. Eddie's just gone up on the deck to have a look, see if we can get the radar to work. He's had some instructions off the engineer, the electrician from New Haven, and he's gone up on the top deck to see if we can get him to work. It's just 10 a.m. and we'll be setting our lights. I think we'll be underway in the next 5 minutes.
Underway now, just left off the dock. About first, you never know.
the guy comes up, the window is still leaking, it's dried it off, there's still more people there.
That's in the bottom corner, quite west, with the tape. And also we've got to, where are we? We've got the, that's it. Now the bottom corner leaking.
Pauline the medic. I'm not sure who that is. And we've come for another day out on the canal boat at Trevor Basin. We've just been told we need to park our vehicle on the other side. Seems quite busy here today, not a very special day. We've just parked the van, we've got to shift it to the 23rd, 8th, 94. Well, we're up on the same boat again, and that's one of young Gallet's friends. What's the young lad's name?
Richard.
Richard, that's Richard. Gallet's just gone aboard. We've got the same boat, of course, the one that's sort of owned for the disabled, specially done.
What are you doing?
Seven Basin again.
I got this frozen shoulder job, you know.
A medic's not in any good condition. Got a frozen shoulder. As long as you haven't got a frozen elbow when we get to the pub.
He's got a pectoral stick, you know.
No.
That was all right. This one I can't live.
And Pam's with me again today. And we brought Nicola. Nicola?
That's
who we brought Nicola with us today. Popsy and Nans couldn't come, so Nicola's come to take their place. And I understand that this gentleman's our skipper for today.
I'm the skipper.
I am the skipper, he's in charge. As they sink down to the deck level on the hydraulic lift. Well, just about everyone's boarded. It appears I'm the last. which isn't unusual. We're in the little basin here, about to sail. One of the barges just fueling up. And of course, there's the little shop. And we have to watch we don't have a fuel spill here. Fueling's done, eh? Well, we've got ourselves a new parking bay now. We've got to move across, but there's plenty of room here outside of a nice cottage. I don't need being bashful today, you know. Nice to see you again this morning, Pauline.
And you, John.
Very similar weather to the last time.
Yeah, very similar. Hope it's going to brighten up.
Sorry?
Hope it's going to brighten up.
Well, it keeps the grass green, doesn't it? Well, the man we thought was fueling up has been doing putting water in. Some of it with that bucket out of the canal, so I'm not quite sure what that water's for, but if someone's got the trucks, that'll probably be the reason. Mind you, the state of the water in place, it might be cleaner out the canal. As long as I haven't done any whoopsies in it.
Birth now. Our old Capitano for the day. What's your name, sir?
John, I am.
You're a John?
That's right.
Same as me, can't be bad. But I've got the animals up on today. Well, yeah, we just come to our... Last time we went over the aqueduct, which is down there, of course. Today we're doing a sharp right-hand turn. Going under our first bridge. If we get rid of the congestion. Now don't be Nicholas, don't be bashful Nicola. Oh, we're underway now, we've clocked about a mile up I suppose. It's a bit on the chilly side today, but it's, at the moment it's not raining. We're slowly making our way towards Llangollen. And Gareth's on the bow of the ship. With his oppo, excuse me young man, what's your name?
Richard,
that's it. Where are you from, Richard?
Bangalore.
Oh, Bangalore?
Yeah.
Oh, aye. We've known some of those Bangalores, don't we, Merrick?
Aye, we certainly do.
It's a lot of work for you, isn't it? Bit chilly today, Pauline.
Isn't it, John?
Yes. All these things tend to try, isn't it?
It wasn't cold the first time it came. No. It was raining, but it was warm, wasn't it? No wind.
Well, Nicola, how are you? What do you think of the trip so far?
Yeah, it's okay.
Aye? Chilly today, don't it? A bit chilly.
Just a bit,
that's it. Well, she got herself towards the stern of the ship, but she's not far up steering it. Not far. Well, looks like one of our first encounters. Slowing down a bit so we don't cause too much weight. It goes up his bow. We've just got off to come ahead of the ship.
Yeah, we have.
I'm sorry, John, the star went to the back of the boat.
Oh, all right. Who's that?
Mona. You shine it through the window, you'll catch her.
Oh, yeah. Hey, Lorna!
Yeah.
Yoo-hoo!
Don't shout,
Well, I've just dashed ahead. I'm on a little bridge.
Is that the bridge too far?
It sometimes appears like when I've been running. Are you coming up here, Nicola?
Here, here. Good, look. Good.
Hey. Oi. Oi. Yeah. Nicola and I are on this little bridge, watching the barge go by. What we got to do now, though, Nicola, is catch up, innit? And we got to run down the path along there and try and catch it up. Yeah. So the ladies are getting some lunch sort of ready. But in there, so I'm going to watch her walk into the bloody canal, of course. Well, there's a very tidy barge tied up here, with all lovely flowers on it. And the guard dog, by the look of it. Isn't it nice?
Yeah.
The little barge we just passed is selling the stuff. Looks like all hand paint. Looks ever so nice. Well, I think we're going to get picked up any time now by our ship. El Capitano is just bringing it alongside. Now and Paulie's busy organising the catering.
Yeah,
doing it all on their own without any assistance from anybody.
Like a banquet,
is it? Oh, eh? Passion's rearing his ugly head, Paulie.
Fagan's back.
Well, we're coming just from behind the hedge, but we'll see it again in a moment. Skipper tells me that it's a boathouse in here. The interesting thing about it is its roof and the slates, which we'll see in a moment. Yes, now the slates there, the first time I've seen them since I picked them up off a sunken wreck and didn't know what they were. And the bloke I showed them to from Dr. Davis from Bangor University tells me they're special slates. It's part of a hotel. Boat out. Now skipper here, John, tells me this piece of canal isn't really a canal. Well, it wasn't originally a canal, it's just a feeder from the river to put water into the canal system and travel. Is that right, John?
That's right.
What was I saying about this tree just along here, John? Is it what?
It's an old tree which is burnt out.
Burnt out?
Burnt out through the middle of it.
Is it? Just by us now?
Yeah, just by you now.
Right. Well, we'll pan along a little bit. Oh, it's by that pipeline, is it?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, here? Oh, yes, look at that. All the inside went on fire, apparently. But as you can see, the tree itself's in quite good nick.
Nice tree, isn't it?
Well, well, well. Well, John, our skipper's just pointed out that an old castle on there. What do you say it's called, John?
It's old castle, that.
And what's the name of it?
Castle.
And that's at where?
Llangollen.
At Llangollen itself. Oh, this is the castle that they talk about in Llangollen, is it?
Right.
And very old. And at the moment, you can hear all the racket, but right alongside the main road here, that goes from Llangollen to Rwabam. This is the A359, is it? 4-8-3. Well, there's our Curtis, who hears me speak very close to his master. And the rest of the ladies,
Well, some of the ladies are in here. Nicola at the moment is trying to hide behind Pauline. Because look at that nan, she happens to be right opposite the table where we've got the spread out. What's a nice spread.
Children
are,
they'll be alright.
Get
rid of the pain. No, I don't take
one.
Excuse me.
Yes, go on, carry on.
Like to your coffee.
Carry
on, Nesta.
To your coffee.
Not too strong.
I'll have coffee as
well. Right, young man, well, how's he going up to now, Gareth?
Great, yeah.
Bit all right, fast. Isn't it? I see your mind is just behind you there, but he's snout like, sticking out.
Good,
he's looking out right alongside you there.
Yeah.
Aye.
Nosy.
Well, we're not far off Llangollen now, no. Gareth. Yeah. And we thank you very much for inviting Pam and I on this trip again. Oh, lovely. Okay. Have you been on these trips before, Richard?
Yeah, the last one.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it was good.
You went a different way the last time, did you?
Yeah, where did we go? That pub we went to with you, John. Yeah.
Oh, it was a good pub, that, didn't it?
Yeah. Really good.
On the way to Chirk, isn't it?
What was it called, man? What was it called, man? The poachers.
That's it, the poachers, aren't you, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah,
something like that.
Yeah.
It's brightened up a bit now, you
know. Yeah.
Well, who'd have thought the weather would be like this in August, towards the end of it? I mean, yesterday was quite a nice day, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, yeah. Yeah. Really warm, actually.
Yeah, not so bad, though.
Yeah.
No. Llangollen, next stop, Gareth.
That's it, yeah. Oh, God.
What's that? That's it.
Oh,
well, we just blew the U-tip because we got a...
See that white stick, John?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I see.
Oh, God, something.
Well, the other barge, the Vivian, has pulled into the side and I think we're going to pass. Gareth,
yeah.
What are we saying about that white stick now?
It means that there's enough room on the canal for you to pass two barges along this stretch, you know? Yeah.
Okay, this is the pole I've just passed now, is it? I'm going to try and catch it. Here we are. That pole there. That's something your dad's just bloody learned, Gareth, I think.
What's that?
The pole means, Merrick, that there's just room to pass once you come to that, on the bend here. Well, they're doing some work on the little bridge here, and it appears to be supported by railway sleepers. It's the bridge we came along earlier on today, and they're doing some work on it. Railway sleepers.
I hit that, you know, John.
What's that, miss?
I thought you'd pinch it back. This came here.
She knit the chocolate
marble. Well, there's the road bridge now. We've just come through the...
Is it all right, Richard?
Yeah.
Through the opening, and we're on to the next stretch.
You got a ball before, Kurt.
Isn't he a good lad?
Yeah, good boy.
It's got nothing to do with that. Oh, nothing to do with them.
Well, that ball was born in.
He's just a good lad.
You're very dignified, aren't you?
Because
stand above it all. You're trying to.
Two boat trips in 2 days, Kurt.
No! See what I mean, didn't he? I have got plenty of food.
Lorna wants to get there before anybody else. Llangollen, I mean.
No escape.
Where have they gone now? Have we got any orange sauce anywhere?
They're coming right now.
Do you know, Mum, the bread's got under the bowl and getting flat.
Let's have a look. Yeah, that Kurt's jumping.
It's good to be here.
Oh, God, look at that going. Do you want the basket?
the mallard one. Well, Curtis here is really keen on these ducks. He'd love to go and play with them.
As he was,
just about a mouthful. Well, they're now following us at high speed. They're creating more buddy bow waves than this barge.
Oh, I'm hungry, aren't I? Yeah. That's another
bun. Yeah, look, he's got his chick with it.
Oh.
I thought they usually had a load of eggs, John.
No, not more hens. Yeah.
It is a more hen, that is
yeah.
it?
Yeah.
I think one of the anglers. That's all it can be, bloody flock here. Well, you're coming to quite a busy little area now. And jammed to pass, so the barge coming towards us have to pull in. Up to now, we haven't given way to anyone. Our skipper is a bit mercenary. I think everyone else seems to be called Jack because he's all right.
Got the right of way.
Get the muscles on that lady there holding that boat back. Well, we're coming through like a little cutting now. And it's fabulous really to see the way the trees are sticking out. All the roots. It makes you wonder.
I normally don't change the fuel.
What's stopping them fall on top of us? Nicola, it's very worrying. I've heard a mumbling once or twice, mummy, you know.
Oh, something we do a lot, that. We change it.
Well, I've told us you'd be alright with it.
Yeah, especially with Abby.
What was that you were saying?
Mummy!
Yes, but you're frightened, mummy. My heart's on the edge of the cliff, mummy.
Here I am in the galley at the moment, and look how close to the side we are. The blackberry's neck can be seen as clear as can be. Probably could be, yeah, there we are. Almost pick them. Well, we're going to a really lovely part now. Trees all the way up. Canal here is very, very narrow. All right there, Gareth?
Yeah, fine, thanks.
Just a job, isn't it, eh? All right, Pam?
Yeah.
Pauline?
Yeah, fine.
Once again, Nicola and I have taken to the path. Really lovely here. Well, we've got more coming ashore now. We now have Curtis ashore. And Lorna. Oh, quick pee. Feels better now.
Nicky, watch that edge.
You must do that.
Hey. We're going to this really nice place. Canal is very narrow. We have a couple of damsels strolling towards us. As the barge trundles slowly on. Hello there, Nicola. Oh, Nicola. Yeah.
Nice staircase that, isn't it?
Yeah, lovely.
Where's our sunny Jim? Here he is. Well, I think we're about there now by the look of things. There's all the bumps. Right, go on, give him a good pull now. Go on, pull him along. Give him some growls. Go on, give me some. Give me some of them now. Go on. Go on, pull him.
This dog's worse than my own. That's how.
Who's the strongest, young Gareth? I think the dog's winning, don't you? Dog's definitely winning here. Well, there's certainly one of my little apples. It's the Jiminy Cricket. And Nicholas is still attacking the dog. He doesn't know he's there. Keep him going.
Got half a dog hanging out of a window here.
Well, we now have, we've just tied up, and Pauline is feeding some other babies. In the meantime, of course, Curtis would love to join in. He'd love a drink of water, followed by a feed of duck and grouse. Just about to go ashore, and our El Capitano has lowered the drawbridge. Don't forget, Gareth, there's a bloody 5 mile speed restriction on the towpath. Don't go anything along like an idiot. Well, we're now all unloaded. And skipper tells us we've got a 10-minute walk to our next turn off, where we're going to that little pub. But Richard here has just gone tear-arsing past me. He doesn't seem to realise that there are speed restrictions on this breakwater, on this towpath. Well, he walks along the towpath and we come to Llangollen Wharf.
Llangollen,
well, I knew that, just seeing if you knew. And we've now got a bit of a walk down the hill. We come onto the main road and what have you. And away we go. At this position, the canal is quite high above the town of Llangollen and the river. There we are, higher than a house. And we're going to make downhill now with the rest of the tribe. To go into the town, whatever. I can think of a few people I'd just send to this man. This is some. Got some very well. Very nicely done, I must admit.
It's all nature, isn't it? Nice, that way.
Yeah, they're very, very well done. Like this, but they are the way it is. I want my father just to keep him happy. Well, Edmund's lying off over the river bridge now. Thought I'd just put my foot in the dollar of dog shit. Nothing to do with Curtis, some other. And it tripped over his, I think. I don't know how to say we're on the famous river bridge. Did ever date Llangollen? We have his master's voice, Jackie Tussle, early. Eh? It's a very nice antique shop here. Hello. I wonder who that reminds me of. Headless. The moment we've got the team in the antique shop, some of them feel very much at home. We've had a nice walk up the river now. And there's people feeding the ducks in the river here. Go upstream a bit. That must be a nice place to live. How high the water goes in severe floods? I don't know. And then we come back down the river. And that's the way it leads to the bridge. But earlier on I was filming upstream. Our team's making their way in this direction. Was that Merrick?
We wondered where you got to. They said you'd be on candid camera somewhere.
Well, that's nice to see.
Sorry.
Hello?
How do you do, sir? One of our jaunts, find a nice local pub, and we ended up at the bridge end. We're going to have a nice quick pint. So hopefully Merrick will have got the drinks by the time I get there. Well, as anticipated, when I arrived at the bar, Merrick had got the drinks in.
The carries are back. Evening, the town's all geared up
for me. My usual lager, Merrick's usual bitter. Pam's got a brandy. Pauline's got a, I'm not sure what, Southern Comfort, that's it. And I'm not sure what Nicola's having. Hard time. And where's Curtis?
Good.
There he is.
Oh,
what a lovely lad. In all his harness.
Just been trodden on.
We're going up the hill now, which is never as easy. On the way back to the ship. Well, what do you think about that, Kurt, eh? Look at these babies here. There's mother, it says come this side where it's safe. In the meantime, poor old Curtis He's having to stand there and watch.
Back at the ranch.
Back at the ranch.
Come on, son.
It's all right, folks. Carry on, no problem.
Okay.
Thank you very much, though. Well, Kurt's wondering where Gareth had got to, but he's found him now. They're showing off walking on the edge of the canal in case you're going to fall in, but he hasn't had a drink, the dog. Well, Nick, so we're on our way back now. Are you enjoying the trip?
Yeah.
What do you think of the skipper?
All right.
Just all right? All right? Listen, if he puts a helm out over, he'll knock you over the side. All right, I thought he's bloody brilliant. That's charming, isn't it, John? She thinks you're all right. Well, John, having heard that statement, what do you think of the crew at the moment? What about Nicola? Rubbish? No comment.
No comment.
No comment. Well, the other thing is, where did that jacket come from, Nicola?
I bought it from a shop.
You bought it from a shop?
Yeah.
That's very nice. How much did that cost you?
£1.50.
You're joking.
Nah.
I tell you what, Pops, you'll have that off you, and it'll be the boot sale tomorrow. Well, Pamela, I was just asking you, Nicola, how she'd enjoyed the trip. How are you enjoying the trip?
Rubbish.
The next thing, what do you think about the skipper?
Oh,
he's
slipping.
Is he?
Oh, he's got a
pardon?
Small pan.
Well, that's different than what Nicola said.
What?
Well, she wouldn't make any comment about the skipper. She's always all right.
Well, I have to say lovely. For Claire's benefit.
Well, we've found 1-2 sheep having a drink of water, so we can't be that bad. Their air's growing better than mine. Arriving back at the site of the tree, was struck by lightning and all burnt out. Look at that, ain't it? Fabulous. Hey? Yeah, nothing wrong with it. All the middle's gone. Look at that. Hey? But the old tree is still surviving. A lightning strike. That's what Merrick has to do when he's fishing for pollock. Lightning strike.
Look at that.
No. There we have Lorna in doing her page Lee pose.
One hand. Page 3 Queen 94.
You're looking all bashful, Lorna.
Don't make it worse, Dad.
What's the matter with you?
Page 3.
Are you trying not to smile?
No. 94.
She's looking at the little bear lambs.
And is it green?
I need a perm, go away.
You need a perm, you should worry. Yeah. We need a bleed transplant. That's not on your hair. Well, fair to our skipper. We're coming to one of many bridges we've been underneath. And in all fairness, the gap isn't very big. Well, there. It would appear we're going to get through without bumping the sides. Oh, Mrs. Morgan can be said if I was going to have a go at it. Well, Nicola's deciding to have a bit of a walk. With, you must notice, Mother, a new jacket on. Which she bought. Look at that, eh? Up, 2, 3, 4, up. For 2, 3, 4, that's the way to do it. Not yet, no. Now what's happening here, folks, is that is Curtis's dinner. And there is Curtis, full of attention. He's just waiting for the word to go. Whenever you're ready, Gareth. Oh, look at that, eh? Was that a whistle, Gareth? Look at that. Is that good or is that good? Oh. We've had all these cakes, chickens and God knows what, the poor old dog's had a thing of biscuits.
Go ham.
Well, we're back to our the little stand. This time I'm on the boat. And there's a little table with all the goodies for sale. Very nice.
They're transfusing them.
And the boat itself is all very nicely done and looked after.
Hello!
It's not amused.
No, they're not going to pay you too long, then.
Yeah.
This fella's done the big green
buckets
and he's
spent on the place. I don't think they're painted.
They're hand-painted canals.
Oh, say, they look hand-painted, they look handmade.
They are hand-painted. Yeah, wood spoon, £1.50, something £1.50, £2.30, £3.50, flags. Leg, you have to
stop and get out.
Well, our Nicola has done a run ahead. I think she's going up the bridge.
She's done a runner.
She's done a runner.
Is she going to jump from the
I hope she's going to do a whoopsie on top as we're passing, you know.
What's the idea? She's going to jump off the bridge? Off the barge?
Could be. Well, not only that, but we also have another ship approaching us. Now Nick has just done a bunk for the bridge, but below it, in the other direction, is another boat. Can we get past? It'll take all the skills of our able captain to pass. Who's that?
There's a dog on the roof.
Oh, there we are.
Hello.
Prepare to prepare to repel boarders.
Yeah. Real mess.
All right, folks, how are you doing?
Good.
Well, we're just about home now. Idle sods on the top deck there, look.
That's illegal.
I've heard that. I didn't realise that. Nigel never told us that, did he?
The other one did,
allowing us to put our lives at risk.
Yeah, especially on the
aqueduct. Handy lad that Nigel, we got it.
Yeah.
Wasn't he?
Yeah.
Not a bad lad. Well, we've got rather a tricky dicky swing round here. But we understand our skipper has got the capabilities of doing it. And you'll notice he stood up now so that the wind gets in his hair and acts like a sail. We're not far off now. Well, it looks to me like our skipper has done it in one. That's very good going, eh? Fair play. Considering this is only his second trip on the boat, he's done very well. Well, that muscular Adonis you're looking at over there in just the shirt, I think is Nigel. Oh, bloody hell. Good afternoon, Nigel.
I can't be the captain here, too busy here.
This lad here did quite well with us today. He hasn't done bad at all. It's not true what he's saying about him.
Why have to stop?
Well, I'm stood ashore now. I've run ahead ashore of filming our boat coming alongside. And our skipper just rammed the bloody key then. Did you notice? Listen to these revs going. Here we go. We'll have a second batch of this. No, it's not fair to say. Our El Capitano wasn't involved with that. Look, I have a feeling that Nicola's falling over that lad there. He is her current heartthrob. Not a bad turn there, fair play.
Yes.
Well, about the end of the trip now, and Gareth's just gone ashore.
Named assisted by El Capitano, John. Well, that's the party about to come ashore. On the lift. Well, we at the end of the trip we caught up with Nigel. I did see him first in this morning, but I got him on film.
We did a runner.
Yeah, well, you did a grand job there, Nigel. Fair play. And where's John gone? John did a great job as well. Yeah, he did. He did. Smashing trip, boys. Thank you very much. You're a credit to the company. Both of you. Well, end of the trip now. A minute of time, back his car now, out of a gap like this. We watched the skipper get the boat out of a smaller gap.
Out of the river.
Out of the river. Cheerio, medic. Cheerio, Pauline.
Yeah.
Cheerio, boys. Cheerio, Lola. In the bay, just been doing a job on the outside moorings, and hey presto, nice sailing ship comes in. Sped to Winestead from Hull. Just been doing a bit of wander around. So, here we are alongside. Gosh, you don't come from that far away, do you, Sarah?
Pardon?
You're not from that far away from Hull, are you?
Newcastle,
9 miles. Hey.
Pardon?
Doesn't matter. Bloody Geordie, she can't understand what I'm saying. Well, I'm sort of sat a bit on the bowsprit here. And it's very tempting for Baxter and I to, you know. Well, here we are. And up the rigging. Not quite at the top. But,
bottle's gone.
Reasonable, yes, aye, as Darren says. Our bottle's gone. It's both of us here. Try and catch up with him. In a... There's our lad. And you'll be a bit bloody careful then, go. I'm not used to this. As you can see, we're a fair way off the deck. Oh dear me.
That's not longer,
it could have been worse, it could have been wind. So there, yeah, what do you think of here, Darren?
Oh, it's a bit high, John, but if I'd be top and I'd jump off.
Yeah, it's just a bloody job it is. And the weather's come out really nice. And there's
Sarah.
There's our Sarah.
Oh, no, where
you come on, Sierra, don't be bashful.
You're gonna look like you're bashing us to everyone.
I'll only show your mother, honest.
Come
in. I'll only show your mummy. There she is. What's that and fall off? I mean jump off. Well, there we are.
What?
Look at my bloody platform, eh? Day down there. We think we're doing well, we jump off that. Well, once again, here we are.
And where'd he go, though?
And Baxi's missing. Sarah? Sarah? Where's bloody Baxi? He's where?
Well, point where he is. She says he's, where is he?
You don't make me look
at the... Oh, look at that, eh? Hey, Pax, stand up and give us a wave.
You look like one of them, holiday making for the tourists. Yeah, I could be here. They wish you were here.
Well, where's, hey, where's Coulson now?
I'm
working his
nuts off.
What's it going to say?
Are you going to slide down the rigging, Fox? You're going to do it the easy way. Okay, mate.
What?
Brilliant, that. Yeah, Pamela, just looking out to see. Isn't it a lovely day? I'm glad you were able to make it. She's looking at little Sierra, sticking her finger up and what have you, you know.
It's like a tourist, isn't it?
Yeah. Like Bernal Day, is this coming it? Something like it, you know.
What's he getting for Christmas then?
God helps that break.
Good.
It's a good place. Shut up, Sarah. Better than North Wales.
You shut up, Sarah. We'll shook in saying things like that.
But I thought you'd stop that packing.
Well, I
are,
you see.
Can I smell something coming on this boat?
Okay, Darren, let's go, man. Let's go.
Not too fast, Darren. That means falls over the top, make sorry.
And off we go. I'm glad Pam was able to make it.
And
that's where Darren and I were stood a little earlier on.
Can you pick us up, Matthew? You know what? You know what? It's not going to break. Oh, cool.
That was that bloody pose there, Pat.
Hey!
Where are you?
Not only have we visited the sailing ship, but we decided last minute we'd come out and have a look at the roast niger. And here's the crankshaft, see where the boat is. There, very close. And, quick pan, he says the boiler just behind me. So very close, as you can see. It's probably a bit too close, but still. The visor's quite good.
Dying, they're molting. I'll pull a little bit of it off.
See the, see the bottom.
Correct.
Well, there we are. Background.
What?
We have the sailing ship.
Sorry.
Well, there we are, way out at sea. And that was Nicola Bob, Nan's dad. What a diving trip, as you can see. It's quite lumpy dumpy.
I think you've probably missed the major fix box.
Well, it's a shame it's a bit rocky wocky, isn't it, Nicola? And Peter's not feeling too good. How is he? He's alright, good lad. When your nan sees this, you won't believe how the sort of seas, there's big swell that's on, Nicola. Nicola? Have you got anything to say to your nan? Like, forgive me, mother. What was that you said, Nicola? What did you say? Hey, turn round again, I got those dimples in your cheeks then. Cheeks on your face, I meant. Oh, well, there we are. It's the rocking and the rolling.
What was that then, Nicola? Your mum just won't believe this. Oh, isn't she doing well? Well, fair play to Nicholas. You're not feeling very well, but she is going to have a go at putting a wetsuit on. Nicholas, is that right?
Yes, sir.
What? That's charming.
Be around security, security.
Nicholas, very much.
All fishing boats in the Liverpool Bay area.
I wish you'd drive up now, Donna.
We've got an ex-course pipeline in the area.
Not feeling good, but she's doing very well. She's got the same sun now.
Shall I like for further information?
There we have the drilling rig.
I hope we have blocking the view out.
Oh yeah, it's
okay. Is Nicola? Right! Diver's up, so I'll have to go.
Carry on, huh?
Yeah, well, Nicola wasn't the only one.
You got the last one.
The leader of our expedition, Wendy, was 100% today.
John?
Hello.
One on the back as well.
Oh, no.
Yeah. Is it
all
right?
Everybody, stereo job.
Oh, that's some good stuff. You know that, did he want the sausage
cutting? I don't think so.
Oh, Peter, I like it, good lad. Where's the jollof? And oh, look at that. What a waste of a good sausage butty. Peter.
Tasted nice.
Taste, you might as well have put it back in the pan, it was hardly used.
Oh, it's on the way home now, isn't it? It's a bit choppy, it's a bit spray coming over. Not bad. I don't suppose this will come out very well, because I'm swimming on my own here. Peter's just out. There they are. But we've got a bit of spray coming aboard. Well, poor old Nicholas at it again. This time he's going to be restrained. Wendy's old enough from falling over the side. Just past Popsy, but he didn't seem to bother too much. Oh, I bet you'll eat your tea tonight, mum, as she gets home.
Ah, she'll be hungry.
Now then, Nicola, look round here. Not half an hour ago, you weren't very well. Have you just had a butty?
Yeah.
How do you feel now?
Better.
Are you thinking of going for a swim now, are you?
Maybe.
Well, if you're going skiing, you're definitely going for a bloody swim. Gareth's going to show her how to do it. She had one, go and fell off. What we started. She's only get better. It's the same girl that was puking up not much more than half an hour ago. Oh, and there she is on her own now. Okay, when you're ready. Well, at this stage of the proceedings, Nicola's fallen off and there she is just ahead of us. Gonna motor around and pick it up, Nams. How's that? You've probably seen this tonight when we call round. There you go. Are you going? You never second go after that. It's harder from there. Go on, away you go. Go on. Just wait, jump. Come on.
I don't have
a header.
twice the height.
You're the only one who hasn't.
Don't change your mind.
Daryl's done it.
This afternoon? Have you enjoyed?
Say yes or no. Have you enjoyed yourself this afternoon?
I know this, you weren't too impressed with this morning, but this afternoon's alright, isn't it?
It took a lot of persuasion to get to jump off the mast. Awful lot of persuasion.
How old are you now, Nicola?
12.
I thought you said you were 11, nearly 12.
Yeah, 12, is it?
Well, hang on, looks like I'm coming to the end of this. So we'll just finish off. Well, there we are, 24th of the 9th, 94. Anyone you recognise? Oh, look at this. Well, you'll never guess where we are, but I'll tell you where we are now. There we have Tom the Post. What time is it, Tom?
7 o'clock.
PM.
9 o'clock in Greece.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, what did you say then, Tom?
9 o'clock in Greece, and Donna's probably on the third bar by now.
And you're enjoying yourself watching the television, I understand?
That's right, in the hospital, yeah.
And at the moment, your better half is in Greece enjoying herself.
Running it up, yeah.
And is her daughter, how's her daughter?
Well, she's been very bad, yeah.
Has she?
Yeah. Okay. Well, she's a bit better now.
Well, look who's here. It's Nicola. All right, Nicola. Oh yeah, I see. We've got a few visitors. We got Nana. There's our Nana. And we've got Auntie Pam.
I'm here.
And I'll tell you what, Donna, I bet you don't recognise the bedroom that your daughter's in. Well, we're back on Donna, on Nicola now. So you'd never recognise the bed, Mother. Well, back up a bit now. I mean, what a well-equipped bedroom you've got for your daughter.
Yeah.
The bed goes up and down.
Oh, a little hat, eh?
Yeah, a little hat on.
Yes, so there she is. Well, you've been away enjoying yourself. You've left your daughter.
I've had about 20 or 30 lots of antibiotics.
Yeah. She's really messed it up for the rest of the family. Because Tom hasn't been having his nights out in the boozy.
All lunchtime.
And Nana and Popsy have had to come here visit him.
Excuse me?
And she's there,
Nana,
living like I don't
Nana
know what.
And Popsy's been once.
Bottlewyden Hospital. News at 10.
Yes.
I'll come
Peter
down to
Sissons.
Nana's house tomorrow and see you when yes. she tears.
I'm not able to do this very often, but there's the cameraman.
It's awful.
JP. Yes,
give me
yes,
something.
How are you?
Energy food. I'm eating them now.
I know. Don't gobble them too much.
Oh yes, she looks very cosy there, eating all the sweets and God knows what. I think she's only making a fuss, her mother, to make you feel, what's that? To make you feel guilty.
To zoom in on that.
I've been on the drip as well.
It's a what?
She's been on the drip. We haven't got that on film.
Been on the drip? Your mother's been, yeah, listen, your old man's been on the drip. Your granddad's been on the drip for years.
Oh, I'm going to switch this off. Sweet.
Well, I must say, it's a very posh place.
It is.
They're all little, they're all little everything.
Yeah,
it's your everything.
Shower.
Really nice. We got the nurses down there keeping an eye on what's going on. Well, they're supposed to be. Da, 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 da. It's really very, very nice there. Very modern.
And
we've just heard that Nicola's sort of... Isn't that bloody television playing? Oh, I beg your pardon. I must admit, the young lady is having a marvellous time. Audrey, can you move your Rumpelstiltskin to one side, please?
That's very nice.
Hello. What's happened?
She's gone home.
I've lost the patient. What we need now is Ruth Rendell. No, not Ruth Rendell. What's he called? Wednesday of the Yard or something. Our patient has disappeared.
She's on the
toilet,
you'll find her there.
But where's she gone? Well, Donna, here's the invalid. She's supposed to be a death's bloody daughter. Doesn't look like it now, does she, eh?
What does it say on there? Good night,
good night.
Good night,
Eki Bauer and goodness. Are those your pyjamas, Nicola?
The colours on the side.
Yeah, that's what
they're saying.
Are
they an issue?
Yeah, I think so, yeah.
Are they the issue?
Are
they? Your own, are they?
Yeah.
Mm. Very nice. You look very smart there. Yes. And where's Popsy tonight?
Well, he's still waiting for his hunters to ring in. I said he couldn't possibly have rung them and said, are they on tomorrow? Well, who was out today? Lexi went out on a phone.
I can see the dimples in your cheek, Nicola.
We've got to find
and
out.
There's Pop. Well, what do you think about this, Tom? Not Popsy.
Tom!
What do you think about this, Tom?
Well, it's ruined my week.
Ah.
Hey, get things work.
You don't just take days off work like that.
That's
not that.
He
did it for you.
Well, she's been well looked after, I must admit. To be honest with you, I think the way Tom and I are feeling, we could do with all the women leaving.
Are, John,
there's two beds in this room. We could do with stuff here and let them all go home.
Two fishing boats.
Who's this friend of yours just turned up?
Your brother, come on.
Nicola, who's your friend just turned up?
My best friend, Nikki.
I beg your pardon, you have to repeat again.
My best friend, Nikki.
Your best friend, Nikki?
Vicky.
Vicky, oh, Vicky, I see. He starts
like
with a V.
Musical act, isn't he, Vicky and Nikki?
Hello there, Vicky. Well, come on now, Vicky, don't be bashful. What's your surname?
Vicky.
Don't usually shy now,
have she's not shy, Mary Allen, she's shy, is she? No, I think this is Vicky's mum. Is that right? Good evening, madam.
Hello.
And it's Mrs.
Evans.
Another Mrs. Evans.
Mrs. Evans as well. Wow.
And who's that young man there? You are Matthew. And who have we got down here? There he is. What's his name?
Thomas.
Good evening, Thomas. You've come to pay a visit to Nicola, have you? Who's not very well. There we are.
She's certainly not.
What time did you phone
the nurse held you down?
About 12, I think it was.
The nurse held you down.
Repeat
your reference, Mother. When you get home, Donnie, you can see that Nicola really is at death's door. I've never seen looks so fit. Where's he gone? This man is hiding in here somewhere. Come on, Thomas, young man. You understand that you rather like Nikki, is that correct?
Yeah.
You're not going to answer me?
What?
Someone, your mother says you like Nikki.
Just say yes.
Yes. She's nice, isn't she? And you come just to see her because she's not very well.
Just say yes. She's
poor. It's nice, that. Does your brother like it as well?
He never left, no.
Does he? Well. Well, well, well. Well, I shall have to ask Nikki now about that. Now then, Nikki, just hear what these lads have been saying. We understand that Thomas the Tank has a soft spot for you. Is that you laughing? I can know. Oh, it's a telly, isn't it?
Yeah.
So is that, he is lovely, the lad, when he's come to see you, when you're not very well. And his brother's got a soft spot as well, is that correct?
No.
No? Well. And there's their sister, who also likes you.
Come back.
who's very bashful. Like the seven bloody dwarfs here, isn't it? And which one's which?
Nesbit.
Nesbit.
Oh, yeah. I beg your pardon, Nikki, you're who?
Nesbit Evans.
Oh, I'm Nesbit Evans, yeah. Where'd you get that name from, Nikki?
They changed the name.
What? Oh, hang on, well, sew me in on that. Oh, it's there on the head of the bed. Nesbit Evans. That's not bloody Rab C. Nesbit, or whatever they call him, is it?
Yeah.
Eh? He's
part
is that the same one?
Part of the family.
Part of the family, Tom.
She hasn't got the vest.
I mean, are you not, you haven't got his vest to wear then?
Should bring that tomorrow night.
I will.
String vest, bring that tomorrow night.
Rab C. Nesbit's string vest can't be bad. Well, there you are. What we have there is young Peter and Gareth having a score round in the sport jack. Lovely day. And it's the first time that Gareth's worn, Gareth Roberts, that is Marion's lad, has worn a wetsuit. It looks like they're going to go towards the Lord of Jane. Fishing has been very good here, we're catching plenty of fish. Well, they've made it to the Lord of Jane, anyhow. Lads are on their way to father's boat now, I suppose. Where is he?
Yeah,
there we are. And there's some quite nice whiting coming in, there's plenty of them. A lot smaller, but some quite nice ones. Quite nice ones, but those lads are getting a bit particular now, they're only keeping the jeans. Well, it looks as if the lighter lads have changed their mind about going to the Lady Jane. It appears you're making for Norman now. Talking about going downwind, but they are. Can't tell these lads. They're not far off Norman now. Oh, another two quite handy whiting. Oh, the boss himself has got these, can't we, bud? Mr. Organiser.
Right.
Yeah, well, it looks like they've just about arrived at the Melwood.
This will be packing in the
what they got to do, of course, is come back against the wind.
How much is all these, Carl? How much, mate?
Well, it looks like the adventurous duo are on the way back. So they got a long way to go.
Instead of putting some effort into it, they're having breeders all along now, and the tide's starting to take them. I did warn him.
Still, just down tide of them is the Lady Jane. Well, it looks like Gareth's got the hang of sculling anyhow. As I said, they are a bit down tide, but they're making well way now.
So we are getting some plenty of nice whiter now.
Every hour was possessed of a snow fever, and I became nervous to emerge from the grieve.
I've got to get a start of me, and I close up these last movement, but he thinks I can't see him.
Right on top of the other boat.
Having a word now, ain't
he? Yeah. Marion's not over-impressed. The blokes may have got their anchor stuck on his by the look of it, it's a guess.
They've drifted all the way along from here, haven't they?
Yeah.
See the anchor line on this side of the boat, isn't
it? Mr. Roberts will be getting most annoyed now. Because it looks like the little boat has got that anchor stuck on his.
Cut it.
The other boat's the other side of it now, yeah. Right alongside him. Oh, there they are now. Stop. Probably snagged all the fishing lines as well.
Stop one lady.
Oh dear. Well, I'm not quite sure what the situation is now, but the small boat's going to be paddling away. And it looks like, well, the ante's okay now. I think Marion's about to make a move somewhere. In the meantime, of course, his son, Mark One, is here on the road with me. They've been doing some sculling, they're just putting the sport jack back.
Jeremy Beadle.
Well, here we have. Well, here we had. The seal has just gone down.
Gone down again.
There's the date. What it is, this gent here has got him on his. Has he taken his line parted? Hey? Well, not done yet, just had the seal. It'll be interesting to see if the gear's still on or not, and what the seal's taken it with him. Well, he's just pulled his line in and it's parted. No weight, no hooks, nothing, so it could be that the seal is dragging it down with him.
Smiling as well.
Well, there's a very nice whiting just come in, look. Do you see that? Hey, hasn't he got a good one? Hasn't he got a big one?
Yeah,
very good, that. And you lads are from Bury, is it?
Bury, well, Manchester.
That's it. Mr. Chase's party from Bury. That makes up for catching the seal just now, eh? Nice whiting, that.
Catching that one's bigger, though.
There's what?
That codling there.
Oh, you've had a codling, have you?
Yeah. What's that?
It's a what? Let's have a look. Well, that's minimum size, I would say.
Yeah, I'd have thrown it back.
Now then, I wonder what that is. How are you, Peter? Are you warm enough?
No.
Mind you, it is the end of October. What the hell are you doing up there, Peter? Are you going for it?
Yeah, I'm just enjoying the scenery. Sorted.
What this young man now on took you and see if he can land you. I've got the gaff ready.
Got him, my hair's all messed up now.
Not the best today, it has been nice, but she started to rain a bit. Couldn't find the airport. Tell you, man. Have a look at the airport.
Could be, yeah, Canada. We just come off that. It's just the start of building.